Gary Mays wouldn't live anywhere but the Gold Coast, and tens of thousands more have the same idea.
It's almost out of control, I suppose.
30,000 people moved to the Sunshine State in 2020.
Now, particularly, you might not have to work in Sydney or Melbourne. You can work from sunny Gold Coast.
With high prices and low affordability across the southern suburbs, many set up home on the more affordable northern end.
And all of a sudden there were buyers everywhere offering cash, offering over asking price.
While 26,000 migrated from Melbourne, many new buyers just came down the M1.
Affordability was definitely surprising at first.
Cafe owner Kieran Skembry was ahead of the curve. 4 years ago, moving from New Farm in Brisbane's inner east to Pimpamar.
Little two-bedroom apartments or little small houses with no backyards to big four-bedroom front yard, backyard places for the same, if not less, in rent.
All that movement has meant prices have also moved up. A long way up. An average Gold Coast home will now set you back $100,000 more than the average one in Brisbane, $638,000 to be precise. Also responsible for high purchase rates on the city's northern end are long-term Gold Coasters who've rented until recently. Now, due to low interest rates and a range of government grants, they've been able to afford a home of their own.
A lot of local first-time buyers, especially in this area.
And with land scarce, they need to get in quickly before prices go beyond their budget. Jordan Bissell, 7 Gold Coast News.